Hello everybody and welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. Fred here speaking, and today we're going to show you some new features about the version of Scriptcase 9.4.27. Well, the first thing we should do here is just check if we already have the latest version of Scriptcase installed. So you can check the version of your Scriptcase installation right here in this user menu. In this case, I'm using the version 9.4.27, which is the latest one. So you can upgrade to the latest version right here, this option menu, then settings. And from here, you can click this Scriptcase update button. Once here, you just need to click this blue button right here to upgrade your Scriptcase, and that's it. Before this process, we recommend you to perform a backup of your project. Once we got the latest version installed, we can create a new project and see the new interface of the project creation process. So let's create a new project. Well, now we can see some changes. The first one is that it's in the full screen mode enabled. Then we have the order of the process is inverted. So first we need to start creating the project, is the same actually. Then we need to connect our database, and finally select the language and theme of our project. In the other hand, in this screen right here, we have all the systems below right here, and if we click here in the see more button, we can see more systems, sample systems actually. Let me open my old Scriptcase. So this is how the other Scriptcase process looks like. We have here the database at the end, and we have all these icons right here. And this is how it looks right now, okay? So let's go ahead and create a blank new project. This is the same screen, same options, icon, project name, and description. So let's go ahead. Good, so right now we need to select the connection. In my case, I use MySQL, but you can also use Oracle or your database. For MySQL, MariaDB, and even for PostgreSQL, Scriptcase will automatically recognize the database char set. So this is something new into this version. So let's go ahead and click in MySQL. Let me type here my password. Remember that this is the password from the database. All right, so let's test the connection. I will type here my sample database. The connection is fine, so let's go ahead. And here automatically Scriptcase will recognize my language and char set. So this is really important. We can of course change the char set type. Just click here in this drop-down menu. But normally by default, Scriptcase will set up it for me, especially with MySQL and MariaDB and PostgreSQL databases. So I will also add French as my second language. You can also add another one. You have a giant list of languages. All right, so let's go ahead. Right now we can select our theme of our project. We need to select one as default. We also can customize and select more than one. So let me open my older version of the Scriptcase. This is how this version looks like. And this is how this new version looks like. Remember that you can also click here and see more themes. You can see your own customized theme, or even a theme from another different version of Scriptcase. Good, so let's go ahead and create our project. And this is the final part of the creation process. Well, as you can see here, the creation process ends in this screen. This is the new application screen. So in other versions, you will see something like this, and it says congratulations and some text over here. So basically we removed this screen, and now Scriptcase goes straight to this new application screen. Another interesting feature here that comes with the latest version of Scriptcase is the possibility of create a grid and a form at the same time. So I will create a grid right now. I have here all the standard options of grid creation, okay? And finally I have this option for also create a form, okay? This form will be based on this table as well. So in this windows right here, we have some preferences. We can set this option as default. And if you change your mind, don't worry, you can go to the preferences and enable or disable this option later, all right? Good, so the second option here is run application, okay? If we click here, we can select the same preferences. Remember again, you can go back these preferences by going to your settings, all right? So basically this option allows you to see how your application will look like, all right? So let me select one of my tables here. I will work with this table city, okay? Normally Scriptcase fills here with the name of my form, and in this case will be my grid and my form, okay? So let's create these two applications. This process takes a while depending on the quantity of records actually. Scriptcase will generate the source code. Good, and as you can see right now, we have here the standard grid application of Scriptcase. But in this case, pay attention here, I have the add new record here, and I can also edit this record, okay? So I can just click here, edit this row. And as you can see, I'm directly to this record right here. So this is a grid. I have all the options of the grid, of course, like the order by, the detail option, and more. And if we go to my Scriptcase, to my applications, let me go back to my Scriptcase. Yeah, let's go to the home page. And from here, we can see that we have two applications created, okay? In addition here, we can go to my grid. So let me open my grid. And if we pay attention here, Scriptcase just created a new application link. So this application was created automatically by Scriptcase. So I can see here all the options and maybe change some settings. But the good thing here is that normally we used to create first the grid, then the form, and then go back to the grid and create the application settings link. So right now, it's not necessary. So this is the end. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you like it, please thumbs up, and I see you in the next time.